cycle of life. We begin from the top and then go below. In between, we have sea, which in the language of the sea is yam. Above all this, we have a sun, which in the language of the sea is called Shemesh. This can be read backwards or forwards. The rays of the sun come down and the sea evaporates, rising up into a cloud of water, which in the language of the sea is Mayim. This also means from the sea, Miyam, and can be read from right to left and left to right. The wind blows the water towards the mountain, where it breaks and materialises into single drops that merge and run down towards the sea, which means Yamah in the language of the sea. The water flows with a force that can move boulders until it reaches the sea, and the fertile erosion it carries settles until the water is again gathered by the sun. And this we call nature, or in the language of the sea, Teva. We may ask ourselves, what is this? Or posed in the language of the sea, ma ele. Ma ele equals the number 81 in the language of the sea, which, as it happens, is also the number nature represents, as Teva totals 81. The number 81, when read from back to front, is 18. In the language of the sea, this adds up to life, chai, which is where we are. With a simple calculation that only life can produce life, since something lifeless cannot produce it, we may now pose ourselves the question, who is this? Or, in the language of the sea, differentiating itself only with one letter, from ma-ele to mi-ele. This now adds up to 86, which, when this is paralleled to nature, it is only equal to it when we consider nature to be all nature, hateva, as this adds up to 86 as well. Scrambling the letters from the second question, mi-ele, we get the name of the god of all nature in the language of the sea, Elohim, which also means god of the sea, el-hayam. Therefore, we now understand its name to be the sea, hayam, being part of all nature, which includes the life we are in. Using this logic of deduction, it follows that we come from a spiritual source, materializing into a single drop or cell that multiplies into other cells and, with the energetic power of youth, can also shift boulders until we settle the soul with good ingredients to the source or sea of life, coming together to form the individual. And this is the cycle of life.